Hello friends, welcome you for watching the video UGC NET examination and overview. UGC NET examination is called as National Eligibility Test. From December 2018, this test will be conducted by National Testing Agency called as NTA. It is conducted two times in a year, that is in July and December every year. This test is conducted for determining eligibility for only the post of assistant professor or for both junior research fellowship, JRF and assistant professor in Indian universities and colleges. Mode of examination is online computer based mode. Each candidate will be allocated their own desktop with a pre-installed software specially formed for the examination. When you enter in examination hall, please make sure to check that the system and the mouse is working properly before starting the examination. Medium of the examination is English or Hindi, and choice for prepare medium, and you can choose any one language, English or Hindi, and choice for prepare medium can be exercised at the time of filling application form. Now, let us see tentative dates for July 2019 examination. Notification will arrive in February 19, last week. Online application forms will start from first week of the March, and last date of filling the application form will be second week of April. And the examination will be conducted in July 2019. Now, it is eligibility criteria. For JRF, upper age limit is 30 years on 1st January. There is no age limit for assistant professor. There is a relaxation of 5 years for OBC, NCL, SC, ST, PWD and women. Relaxation will also to the research experience and LLM degree. Educational criteria will be masters in the subject. Now, examination pattern. There are two papers. Paper 1 is general paper and paper 2 is based on subject selected by the candidate. In both the paper, objective questions will be asked. We have to select the most appropriate option from given options. All the questions are compulsory. There is no restriction to move to and fro among the sections. That means you can solve any question first. There are 2 marks for each correct answer and no negative marking. Paper 1 contains 50 questions and duration is 1 hour. Paper 2 contains 100 questions and duration is 2 hours. And the examination will be conducted in 2 shifts. In first shift, first paper will be conducted from 9:30 to 10:30 and second paper will be conducted from 11 to 1. For second shift, first paper is in the time 2:30 to 3:30 and second paper is in the time 4 to 6. Now, some important notes. If a question for any reason is found to be incorrect, the benefit of marks will be given to only those candidates who attempt the question. That means if NTA found that some question is asked in wrong way, there are incorrect options, whatever may be, then question arises to whom the benefit marks are given will be given. It is decided that the benefit of mark will be given to only those candidates who attempt that question. So, instead of skipping question, use guess and place the answer. Don't skip this question. Now, let us see about application fee. For general category, application fee is 1000 rupees. For OBC, it is rupees 500, and for SC, ST, and PWD, it is 250 rupees. Now, cutoff. For general category, cutoff is 40%, and for others, cutoff is 35%. But remember, this is a competitive examination, and for that, we have to score higher marks. Don't depend on the cutoff. Tips for getting success. First, know the syllabus. Second, prepare your own notes. For preparing note, you may take help of your teacher or experts. Solve the previous year's question papers and model papers. Before solving question paper, prepare and understand each and every topic. For time management, try to solve many test papers, which will increase the speed and accuracy of solving the question paper. Start your preparation well before. That means you can start your preparation for today only. Follow regular study routine to complete the entire syllabus. Watch the videos prepared by Yashodhan Competitive Mathematics and subscribe this channel for getting updates about the NET and SET examinations. The website for NTA is www.ntanet.nic.in. Now let us see the syllabus of first general paper. This is paper on teaching and research aptitude. In this paper, question will be of general nature and to assess the teaching and research attitude of the candidate. Also, it is to test reasoning ability, comprehension, general awareness, and divergent thinking of the candidate. Syllabus of this paper is divided into 10 parts. First part, teaching aptitude. It contains teaching nature, objectives, characteristic and basic requirement, learner's characteristics, factors affecting teaching, methods of teaching, teaching aids, evaluation system. The second part is research aptitude. It contains meaning, characteristics and types of the research, types of research, methods of research ethics, paper, that means research paper, articles, workshop, seminar, conference and symposium, thesis writing, its characteristics and formats. Third part is reading comprehension. In this part, passage is given to read and candidate have to answer the given questions. Fourth part, communication. In this, there is a nature, characteristics, types, barriers and effective classroom communication. Fifth part is reasoning. It includes mathematics. It contains number series, letter series, codes, relationships, classification. The sixth part is logical reasoning. It includes structure of argument, evaluating and distinguishing, deductive and inductive reasoning, verbal analogies, word analogy, applied analogy, verbal classification, reasoning, logical diagrams, simple diagrammatic relationship, multi-diagrammatic relationship, Venn diagram, and analytical reasoning. Seventh part is data interpretation. It includes sources, acquisition and interpretation of data, quantitative and qualitative data, graphical representation and mapping of the data. Eighth part is ICT, that is information and communication technology. It includes meaning of ICT, advantages, disadvantages and uses of ICT, general abbreviation and terminology, basics of internet and emails. Ninth part is people and environment. It includes people and environment interaction, sources of pollution, pollutants and their impact on human life, exploitation of natural and energy resources, natural hazards and mitigation. 10th part is higher education system, polity and administration. It includes structure of institutions for higher learning and research in India, formal and distance education, professional, technical and general education, value education, governance, polity and administration, concept education and their interactions. Subscribe the channel Yashodhan Competitive Mathematics for getting more updates of NET, SET, JRF examinations. If you like this video, please press like button and share this video with friends so that many students can watch video and get benefit. Thank you. See you again. Wish you best luck.